Well, thank you, and good morning, everybody. If this is European democracy in action, as we've heard this morning, I suggest we have a rethink. We're told that, as a result of the European elections, Mr. Juncker here is the nominee. Well, I can tell you that absolutely nobody in the United Kingdom knew that when they voted in the European election, it had anything to do with the next nominee. And the truth of it is, your voters, actually in your countries, didn't realise what this process was. Mr. Juncker's name did not appear on any single ballot paper. Now, of course, I'll be told, but hang on a second. The European Parliament, the elected bit of the European institution, did actually have a say and did decide whether Mr. Juncker was to become Commission President or not. Well, let's just have a think about the process we're about to engage in. We've all got to be asked to vote, and we've got one candidate to vote for. But I think far worse than that, it is going to be a secret ballot. I mean, you really couldn't invent it, could you? I mean, what is clear is you are going to carry on with the process of the centralisation of powers, which is not surprising, because for 20 years you've been a key player in this whole process, which frankly has treated democracy with deliberate contempt. I think the best example is your quote about the French referendum on the Constitution, where you said, if it's a yes, we will say on we go. And if it's a no, we will say we continue. How's that? How's that for belief in democracy? And you said at the end of your speech, this is not the time for a revolution. I put it to you, there's already been a revolution. There's effectively been a coup d'etat on nation-state democracies. Without people realising, because the vast majority of European people don't want a European state, don't want a European Commission to be the executive, don't want that flag, and don't want that anthem.